just me catching my breath. That is not easy to do. All right, Braintree High, welcome to the 8th edition, the Ocho of Dancing with the Staff. Oh, please, I feel you can do much better than that. So this is the 8th edition of Dancing with the Staff. Ooh, baby, there we go. All right, tonight you will see high quality, incredibly talented state championship dancers. And you will also see the dance team. The teachers have worked hard on this. They have put their time on this. They have given you all A's, they ignored grading you difficulty for this. And now you get to judge them. They gave you a D, you don't have to clap. But let's be honest, you're going to, it's going to be amazing. But it's not just about the clapping, there is judging. Oh, there's judging. Silent judging and very public judging with numbers. And doing that judging tonight for us, we have an esteemed panel of judges and Michael Kelliher. The first judge that we have is dance coach Patty Hale. And then for the first time, not dancing, but sitting behind the judges' table, dance coach Mrs. Panza. And another new judge this year, literally the world's nicest human being, Mrs. Barbara Johnson. That's Barbara Johnson. That will round out the adult portion of the judges. But after that, we do have a series of child judges. We have the aforementioned QB1, Michael Kelliher. How dare you. And then, in the absence of Mrs. Moynihan, our usual head judge, we have a new head judge this year. You might know her as the voice of Friendly Friday. Or that girl in your class who, when she starts laughing, just can't stop. Head judge, Colleen O'Riordan. This is a velvet jacket. I am sweating aggressively. This is unpleasant. Oh. Thank you all for singing with me. I really appreciate it. That made it much easier for me. Are you still in the mood to keep singing? Yeah. All right. I don't know if you know anything about me, but I am a happily married man. That's right. Someone took this. Velvet jacket and all. And it was my wife's birthday. So I was wondering, you don't have to sing, but if we can, on the count of three, just wish my wife a happy birthday. She is in here, but I can't shine the spotlight on her because then I would no longer be married. So on the count of three, we will wish her happy birthday, Mrs. Daly, in 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday, Mrs. Daly.
Take that, Jameson. All right. Now, I know that you are ready to see the dancing begin. You are poised and ready. You are in the front row seat. You are ready. You are foaming at the mouth with dance fervor. But don't you want to see what went into these dances? How hard they had to actually work? No? Well, I don't care what you want. I have the microphone. I can do whatever I want. BHS News has put together an incredible behind-the-scenes look for us. So without further ado, we'll open the curtain up and give you a behind-the-scenes look at what goes into Dancing with the Staff.
I have absolutely zero dancing experience.
This time last year, I think we had a week extra to practice, so I'm very nervous.
They're a little slow.
Do I think we have room to improve? Yeah, everyone has room to improve.
We're working double time this year. It's only day two. We already have a lot down.
I think I got the dream team. I don't think anyone can compare, honestly.
And
yeah. Buddy's fun.
She cracks the whip.
That's
she cracks
right.
the whip.
That's right. That's right. Buddy's always fun.
I want to watch TV. Nope. We need to practice again.
It seems like they snuck out to go to a faculty Christmas party. I don't know what that's about. They are very dedicated to the Dancing with the Staff.
I think that the whole Mr. Delery thing is just a gimmick. I don't think he's really going to bring much to the table.
No, I'm not intimidated by Mr. Delery. I don't know why people keep asking this Mr. Delery question, but no, I'm not scared of Mr. Delery.
I'm not. See, like this, it's like crushing a bug.
Like a little bug.
Yes.
Un insecto chiquito.
There he goes. There he goes.
I'm confident that he's going to perform well, but I really don't think he's going to be the element that puts us into second place.
Style and elegance and grace.
A certain flash in your dance.
The cleanest. People who look like they're having a good time.
We're gonna win.
Gotta come back and take some revenge here.
I know our team can win.
So this year we're coming back for the top here.
I think we have a really good chance of winning compared to the other teams.
Yes, absolutely. I think we're gonna kill it.
Dancing's not my thing. It'd be nice to win something I've never won before.
Here we go. There we go. All right. Now, that was put together entirely by students. Now, if you'd like to know who those students are, I'm going to read their names to you momentarily. That would be Katelyn Carrara. Oh, we're going to clap for all of them, sure. Mary Kelliher. Maria Alvaran. Declan Casey. And Annabella Valle. If we just got another round of applause for WampTV for putting that all together. You're working really hard. But let's be honest. You aren't here for videos. No. You aren't here to see me sweat. Maybe you are, that's weird. But what you are here to see is to see your teachers get up here and show you what they can or can't do. Coming up first, it is Muy Caliente, the world's most adorable duo, Disney Plus, Mr. and Mrs. Jameson.
What's bothering me? I wanna be a man, man, come on, it's true.
Different ideas we can do, and then somebody said, why don't we do Disney? And then we're like, sure, let's go for it.
Well, all right. I guess that's better than Game of Thrones. That would probably be bloodier. So, just wow. This is just terrifying. Now, typically you're known for your incredibly romantic, passionate dances that we've learned that you practice in the kitchen for hours on end. How many hours did this year's dance take?
Ooh, this year wasn't in the kitchen, it was in the dining room. Yeah, we had 1 week less, so I don't know. Can't count them. But you wish you had this hair.
I mean, I could just do this, and now I have this hair. One more time for the Jameson. All right. I guess do we have a broom anywhere? Oh, okay. That little kid said no. All right. Jamesons are now the second most adorable thing here. Well, contending with this flurry of paper goodness, we've got a new team, a strong team, a manly team. Oh, I'm sorry. I just failed miserably. There's all this paper. There's Jameson's crazy hair. I can't do it. We need to get some scores. We should have kept them on stage. That's okay. They'll be surprised too. We'll start with head coach Hale. What have we got?
What is
the
nine?
Oh, we've got a nine. Right now, instead of standing here sweating, they are backstage eating snacks. Maybe they're happy. Dance was Panza. What did you give them?
Oh, nine. Ooh.
Barbara Johnson, we talked earlier that you can't give every single person a 10 and a hug. What did you give them?
10.5.
program, we can only put that in as a 10. That is not a real number. Now, I bet you're wondering, what did head judge Colleen O'Riordan give them for a score? What did Mikey Teller put for a score? Can Mikey count above 4? I don't know. But we will not find out their scores yet. No, no, no. Those will stay until the end. That way, we won't know who's going to win. I'll know, but you will not know. And you will have to wait till the end to find out. If you don't like that, I really don't care. That's okay. But what we've got now, now we're actually going to get into the second dance. We are ready for them. Strong, powerful men. Men that will hip-hop their way into your hearts. I don't know if that's a thing that you can do, but they're going to. We have Mr. Maza and Mr. Ritz. I don't want to talk about the jorts, but I feel like we have to talk about the jorts. Did the jorts give you more freedom this year to move around? Last year you were in a spacesuit, this year, jorts.
They actually were jeans that I had to cut for flexibility purposes, so.
Flexibility purposes. Flexibility purposes. Okay. just feel like he's gonna palm my head the whole time. Don't, please don't touch me. Now, Mr. Ricks, you are not from Massachusetts. You are not. That is okay. Not everyone's perfect. How do you feel the style of teacher dancing in Massachusetts compares to that of Ohio, where you're from? Wait, that's okay, take a second, think about it. Ohio, the land of, whatever you want to call it. Tall people. Do you feel like you're gonna run this back with your phys ed class tomorrow?
Definitely.
Okay, man a few words. Ooh, okay. Now you guys are sadly, my mistake with the Jamesons will not be repeated, so you will be staying here to receive your scores. We're gonna start this time with Barbara Johnson so she can't go rogue and make up a score like Flippity Seven. Miss Johnson, what did you give them?
9.1.
You're a monster. Oh, it's not true, I take that back, I'm sorry. Dance Coach Panza, what did you give them?
8.5.
And last but certainly not least, Dance Coach Hale.
Well, I gave a 9 because of the flip.
Woo! Let's flip that way right into our heart. One last time for hip hop into your heart. Well, we've seen two dances. That takes us a portion of time throughout our show. Get off your phone. Get off your phone. What are you doing? You're in the front row. What? What we are here for now I feel like it's time that we should learn a little bit about the people judging. They are not up here sweating and potentially embarrassing themselves. So now I'm gonna ask them a series of difficult questions that will call into question their ability to be judges, and should they be judging others? I wanna come right down. Ooh, yeah, now it's real, isn't it? Who am I gonna talk? Who do you want? Who do you wanna hear from? Okay, we're gonna hear from Colleen. All right, Colleen, now, every day, you're the friendliest human being in the building, except for Mrs. Johnson. But every Friday, you share with us something that we can do to be friendly. Here at Dancing with the Staff, what could we all do to be friendlier?
We can clap even when the dance is bad.
No dances are bad here, Colleen. No, that's not a thing, that they can't be bad. Did they not tell you this when you came in? You didn't read your pamphlet. That's okay. Ms. Johnson, you asked me repeatedly, over and over again, to please not ask you a question. I don't know if you're with me. I still have the microphone directly in front of you. So, what do you feel your dance specialty would be if you were up there?
I was very good at the twist. Disco.
All right. Calypso. Do you want to name a dance that any of these kids were alive for? Okay, all right. There's so many judges to talk to. That's not true, I only have 5. Which dance coach would you like to hear from? Hale or Panza?
Tell
me about a dance coach. I don't know if you're aware of that, you're just making things up now. We're gonna go over here, we're gonna hear from dance coach Hale. Now we are looking at multi-state champ dances, just over the top. If they lose, it's never a thing that's happened, so we don't honestly know what that's like. How would you deal with these teachers if they were actually on your dance team? Bearing in mind we can't say hit them.
Well, Mr. Wakelin should be on the dance team.
A lot of love for Mr. Wakelin. Anything else?
Well, I think they all do a really great job, and they just have to keep practicing.
Keep practicing, okay. That's a good life advice. I was going to jump back on the stage, realized I couldn't do that. Now, if you were expecting another teacher dance team, sorry, not time for that yet. What we've got now is a JV dance team that is better than most towns' varsity dance teams and most local colleges. So without further ado, JV dance. The kid sitting there, just no respect for her at all. That is dedication to WampTV right there. Another round of applause for our tech crew here. They are making the curtains close, they are making the sound go, they are putting this glaringly bright light into my face that is making me sweat aggressively. That's the fourth reference to how much I'm sweating tonight, if you're keeping track. JV dance team. They learn their dance, the dance they do with the teachers, a final routine, and then some of them even dance with me. So that is a lot of dances, and they learn them all flawlessly in 4 seconds. They're just like, oh, I'm just gonna do this, bing, bop, boop, bop, and then they're done. And then it looks like they've been doing it for years, and all of the teachers, myself included, look like we're about to break our hips. Except for Mr. Ritz, nothing on him is breakable. Now, what, you might be wondering, do they get for this, besides the personal satisfaction of besting all the other teachers, which matters if you're a psycho like me. But it matters, and what do you get? You get this incredible trophy up here at the front. Can we get a little light on that? Is that possible? Can we hold it up? There we go, look at it, shine. And then the teams of teachers will have to pass it awkwardly amongst their rooms for the duration of the year. Last year, we had our first team of all female teachers to win. Girl power. Yeah. Okay, that seems odd that there's not more love for women in this audience, but okay, sure, whatever you guys are into. We have a lot of teachers here. Mr. Cooper could tie for becoming the winningest dance teacher of all time. That would be 4 wins if he was to win tonight. Mrs. Violette, Miss Eckler, Miss Jacobs, and Miss Nelson could be the first team to repeat in 5 years. That's an important thing. But now we've got something different. Last year we had a team of all women that won. Now I'm about to show you a team of nothing but raw, unadulterated testosterone. It's a team called Hotline History, and it has all misters: Flanagan, Hopper, Baker, and Ritland. How this works when the music stops, that's usually that's me. Okay, all right. Where to begin? Well, Mr. Baker, your head is glowing like the trophy, so we'll start down here. As a man who was sweating himself 5 times, why would you decide to wear a winter coat?
I thought it was time for this to go from 0 to 100 real quick.
That was fantastic. Oh, we're still doing this? No, that's okay, that's okay. Don't worry, I'll get to you, but people...
My boys over here.
I think you just waved at a group of small children. Mr. Ritland. second year in a row you've done some acrobatic moves. How are you holding up?
You know, all these moves, it takes a lot of practice, but you know, it was just God's plan.
I'm getting a theme here. Stop, say, why are you so intimidating? You're the most masculine human being, you're staring into me. So, Mr. Hopper, besides being wildly intimidating, you brought in a new energy to the team. How was it being out here on the dance floor?
You know, it was a lot of fun, and I could say that we just needed one dance.
Okay. One dance. Yeah, not so comfortable now, is it? Don't follow me, that's weird. Do you want to come up here and say hi to him? You can, you want to come up? He'll come to you, he's going to come to you. This is the new most adorable thing. How was it being the spectacle as opposed to hosting the spectacle?
All I know is we started at the bottom, now we're here.
Now they're here. Judged. We'll start with the harshest judge. Dance coach Hale, what did you give them?
A 9.
We've got a 9. Dance coach Panza.
9.5.
Ooh. Now, Ms. Johnson, we talked about this. We're aware of what the scores can go to. They end at 10. I know you can do this. What score did you give them, Ms. Johnson? One more time for Hotline History. So now you go out the door. There you go. If you're in the back and you are wondering what that sound you keep hearing is, that is just Colleen laughing. Big scores there. I don't know if Ms. Johnson's score mathematically counts, if we can actually give a team 100 points, right? That's 10 squared, right? That's a real question. I don't know. Okay, thank you. I don't think that's actually an amount of points that we can give, but that is a pretty high score. But remember, we don't know what the students have given for a score. They could have given it a 2. Maybe they just really hate Mr. Flanagan. I don't know how that's possible. He's a delight. But we don't know. We don't know what kind of bribes have been slipped into Mikey's pocket over the course of this week. We don't know. And we won't find out until the end. But since we're in the mood for dancing, we've got another team that's ready to steal your hearts. I don't know if you're ready for these dancing queens, this bohemian wompsity. Miss Lobby, Mr. Cooper, and Mr. Wakeland. With this velvet jacket, I was gonna have jacket of the night. I was incorrect. What would you call that material?
Uncomfortable.
Oh. That was a snort. All right, we're gonna stop and head ladies first. We're gonna start with Miss Lobby. Miss Lobby, on a team with two dancers like Wakeland and Wakeland complimented by the dance coach, how do you keep up with these beasts of the dance floor?
It's not easy, Mr. Daly. It's really not. I'm a girl, and we're a playing queen, so I'm really at the bottom of the totem pole, but we pulled it off.
Pulled it off, all right. We're gonna go with Sunshine over here. Now, Mr. Wakeland, Dance Coach Hale singled you out as the teacher who could be on the dance team, could be a multi-time state champion. Are you gonna quit your job?
Do you allow 30-year-old teachers to join the dance team?
We might. That's not like an easy yes or a hard no. That seems confusing and uncomfortable. I guess we'll have to try out, but I think you'll be all right. How do you feel about this year's dance compared to years past?
Every year we try to amp it up a little bit, and this year I've never been more sore than this week. I literally, the last like 2 days, couldn't even do some of the moves because it was so sore. I had to like save myself for this.
Saved himself for dancing with the staff. This is where the energy to teach your children is going. Now, Coop, if you were to win this year, that would tie you for the most wins all time. But that isn't actually what I want to ask you about, nor is it this immaculate tank top you've chosen to run. I want to know, can we get a Deo? There we go. And then I gotta ask, how does the mustache feel? Could this be a new Mr. Cooper look?
Not a chance.
That's not a chance on the mustache, okay. Well, we're gonna see what Barbara Johnson feels about the mustache. She's probably gonna give you some kind of ridiculous score like a symbol for infinity. But Miss Johnson, what have you opted for this time? 10 cubes! Miss Lobby just said 1,000 because she knew that I wasn't going to know that. Thank you. Dance Coach Panzo, what did you give them? That's a 10. Dance Coach Hale, what did you give to your prospective dance team member? Actual 30 for the night. Thank you. Have you been around for this? Now remember, just because it looks great for them now, we don't know. Because we don't know if Colleen has actually been writing scores down. She might just make them up at the end. We don't know. She's still laughing. Now we're getting to the point that everyone came for. There was one dancer tonight that stood out above all others. And I don't just mean Mr. Ritz, because he literally stands above all others. This is the first time in the history of competitive student-teacher dancing, that's a thing, that we have got a housemaster dancing on stage. Is it Miss Moynihan? No. No, it's not. Is it Mr. Reardon? I'm glad that you feel that way. No. We've got a team called Delery's Dancers. So if you haven't already figured out from that name that it's Mr. Delery, you are not very good at this game. Dancing with Mr. Delery, his aforementioned dancers, we have Miss Jacob, Miss Nelson, Miss Violette, and Miss Eckler.
You are, baby. One more lies, one more lies. One more lies, all your
well for your chances. That's still Colleen laughing. All right. Well. Doesn't matter, you're still getting suspended. You know what you did. I'm gonna give them a chance to catch their breath after all that Britney-ing. Yeah, how's the other side feel now, huh? Yeah. All right. Miss Jacobs, we're gonna start down here because we're only allowed to keep the spotlight on you for so long, otherwise everyone in the audience will go blind. How do you feel about this year's dance compared to last year's winning dance?
I think this year's dance was a lot more fun to dance.
A lot more fun to dance. The ringmaster has thoughts. Oh, there we go. Now you've dressed up as the ringmaster. Would you say that you are the ringmaster of this team?
Yes, she is.
Obviously, I am.
A team called Delery's Dancers. You are obviously the ringmaster. I just want to make sure we're on the same page.
Oh, we're on the same page.
Okay. No, not yet. It's not time. Miss Nelson, how did it feel adding in Housemaster Delery when we all know Housemaster Moynihan was your first choice?
I think we upgraded.
Sassy. Now we come to Miss Violette.
Yeah!
I heard you yell Miss Joyce, it's Miss Violette. Please get it correct. That's ridiculous.
Yes!
He liked it, so he put a ring on it. Okay. Miss Violette, how did this year feel? This is now, what, year five? Five dancing? Five doesn't mean anything special in terms of this, but how did it feel? You're like a crafty veteran now.
Challenging. I was real nervous yesterday, but I thought, just channel my inner Britney and I would be just fine. So I did.
Okay. I don't know what it means to have an inner Britney, but I guess that's the thing. Mr. Jelly, do you have an inner Britney? Now, I don't know if you're aware of this, but are you going to write yourself up for being out of dress code up here? Like, how do you deal with that? When you are the Violet, do you violate, like, how does that work? Do you write yourself up?
Well, Ms. Moynihan and Mr. Reardon are here, so if you guys won't tell, I won't tell.
Well, we've got one more, Ms. Lee. There's no way we're gonna let you get out of here being the first judge to ever make the transition to performer. How does it feel on the other side?
I don't have anything witty to say other than it was just awesome. It was a lot harder and a lot more fun. Our dance team girls were just incredible with us all week, so patient with us. And it was awesome. Tons of fun.
Tons of fun! All right, now it's time to get the scores. We'll start with you, Miss Johnson. What have you done? Have you drawn a dinosaur this time?
Infinity!
And yet we're gonna get the rest of the scores anyway. Dance Coach Panza. 10! Will it be a perfect sweep? Dance Coach Hale? Kelliher, you are free to go. What a gentleman. In case Johnson's scores have been 10.5, 9 point something, infinity, 10 squared, and 10 cubed, none of which are all valid scores. Are you 100% sure you know where you are right now? Staff, we're close. All right, we've seen the novices. We felt what amateur dancing feels like. It's time to see what real dancing looks like. So without further ado, here is your state champion dance team. Velvet coat? You do not. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the final dance number for the night. But now the judges will be tabulating their scores and figuring out who is actually going to take home that disco ball trophy. And by take it home, I mean put it awkwardly in the corner of their classroom. But we've got a couple things. I don't know if you've noticed while we're going around here, but there are multiple cameras set up around here, all around the auditorium. We had this poor young lady get swept on right here, making sure she could get the shot for all of you. WampTV is going to put that all together. And I don't know if you saw it when you came in, but they are trying to raise $250. And if they hit that amount, they are going to upload the full version to YouTube so that you can watch it anytime. If you want to freeze frame on the moment where you saw Mr. Delery sweating, you can do that. If you want to freeze and just stare at Mr. Jameson's wig endlessly and be terrified forever, you can do that. Right now, we are only $70 short of that goal. So I would ask that you, on your way out, really think about donating. Now, you get to watch the video when you make the donation. That's wonderful and fantastic, but what is the school going to do with it? We are going to be able to send those kids to Washington, D.C. to further improve their video making skills. So if you love this video, the next one will be even better. All this stuff doesn't happen without them. So we want to give them another round of applause, please. All right, well, currently the judges are tabulating the scores, but we do have a final dance number. We want to get everyone back up on the stage, so I'm going to shuffle off to give them the space to do so. Here we go, one more time, all your teacher dancers. they can see you. They want to see your faces. That's what they paid to see. I mean, we've already seen the backside of all the history teachers, so we might as well see their faces. I don't know if that's a you're welcome situation. That's more of a sorry situation. All right, take a look. This is the people. These are the people that have entertained you all night. Another round of applause for them, please. While I am doing an assortment of thank yous up here and not killing time, I would like you to go get the superlatives if you could. Oh, they're making their way up to me right now? Fantastic. All right, first up, we have to thank the entire tech crew. That's why I've got my sheet of paper. Normally I have to go off the cuff, but I could not memorize all these kids' names. So, on the tech crew, in no particular order, we have Cindy Dang. As great as Cindy is, I'm going to read through the rest of them. We can save the applause while I read through all of them. Otherwise, we will be here all night, and I'm sure everyone has places to be. Then we've got Charlie Lewis, Tanisha Carter, Cole Barry, Alex Cusin, and Liam Garrity, the tech crew. We've also got the aforementioned WampTV Road Crew. So Cheung, Katelyn Carrara, Colin Doherty, Maria Alvaran, Darren Damon, Mary McDonagh, Shannon Stufo, and Maggie Richard. Shannon, I am sorry, that is what they wrote. It is awful. If you want me to fix that later, I promise you I will. WampTV Road Crew. We also need to thank our judges. That is Dance Coach Hale. Dance Coach Panza. The world's nicest human, Barbara Johnson. A man I didn't get a chance to speak with much tonight, Mikey Tallier. And finally, I have no idea what you yelled, but no one understood it. But now, thank you for stealing the spotlight, because we're going to talk about head judge Colleen O'Riordan. And then I want to give yourself a round of applause. Thank you for coming out to support the dance team. Teachers for participating by handing them out a superlative. Every teacher will get a superlative. What will they get? The one they put on top is for me as best host. Thank you very much. That literally looks like the most self-serving thing ever. All right, right now we've got best trick. Best trick goes to Mr. Maza. Next up, and always important award, Most Improved. That award goes to Mr. Ritz. We probably all know this one. The Best Toe Touch goes to Mr. Ritlin. The most dedicated dancer. This could be almost anyone, but it's not. It's Mr. Cooper. The most spirited award goes to Miss Eckler. award that we've got, apparently the best sassy walk. That goes to Mr. Flanagan. That is the one he wanted. That is terrifying. Most likely to be a Rockette, Miss Violette. Ooh, here's an impressive one. Most likely to be on the dance team. It's not who you think it is, it's Mr. Hoppert. I feel like this is the easiest one ever. Most likely to be a Disney princess, Mr. Jameson. Whoa, that's Mr. Jameson. Now we've got most competitive, Miss Lobby. An award called Best Drake Moves. We probably have had that for a long time. That goes to Mr. Baker. Next up, we have Best Musicality. Musicality. Mrs. Jameson. Most likely to make it on Broadway. Broadway. Miss Jacob. Colleen, are you okay? Next up, we have Best Technique. Mrs. Nelson. We somehow have an award for best dancer. I don't know that we have that. Best dancer. There's only two left. It's one of two people, but it's... Yes, it is! For the evening, the rookie of the year. Little drum roll, sure, why not? Mr. Delery. To the best of my knowledge, we are still tabulating scores. Scores are still being tabulated. This is what I've got. So, okay. I'm just gonna go right to the top. We are going right to the first place team.
Yeah.
Addendum, they are all written on the back.
What up, Sal?
You did, this is you, isn't it, Talia? This is what you did. This is for not interviewing you. I'm sorry. In fifth place. Yeah, that, what, you don't want, oh, first you wanted it, now you don't want them? So selfish. In fifth place. Nope, we're gonna go to third place.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, all right, look, what do you want? The dance coach usually does this is not my thing. I just have mean-spirited jokes about them. That's what I do. All right, so here we go. In third place, the bronze medal. Drum roll, please. Hotline History. Yeah. second place. Gallery's dancers. Probably thinking the varsity dance team is going to win because they are clearly the most talented group of people up here. They are not actually eligible to win. So if we could get a final drum roll, please. The winners of Dancing with the Staff 8, the Ocho, Bohemian WampTV. Ladies and gentlemen, that is our show. Drive safe.